Kia ora tefano. Before we get started on this week's episode, I just have some really exciting news. So pleased to announce we're partnering with the Lad Collective on this Aussie series. If you don't know about the Lad Collective, two brothers, Ed and Bill, who have started a bedsheet company that's all about creating easy to use bedsheets that empower young men to start to take care of their bedding situation. Now, you know our saying here at the Boys of Decorating is, how are you going to learn how to look after yourself if you don't know how to look after what's around you? If you could drop a thank you to the Lad Collective just below in the comments. Literally, this whole Aussie trip would not have been possible without them. So we can't thank them enough for their support. Hope you enjoyed the episode. All right, we're at Kempy's new spot. Is there anything you want to tell us about this before you take us in?
Well, like, I'm not saying that this is true, but I've heard people call it the Mecca of rugby league. I didn't say that.
That smart might have been.
Heaps of good games there. Great start. Shit career. Worst Warriors signing ever.
Welcome to the studio, guys.
Holy shit.
Did I ever think that we'd be something like this? No, I did not.
Yeah, it's humbling. It's really humbling, bro. Like, it's like one of those things where you get used to it, but then eventually, like, each time you're feeling a bit stressed or, oh, you know, the show went for 4 or 5 hours or whatever it is, and you go, are you serious, bro? Look at the incredible, how lucky you are to have something like this and create content in it.
This is amazing, man. Because I can see there's kind of like four clearly defined areas. Yep. So take us whichever one you want to go.
We'll go to where I interview the players. So we'll go across to here. Now this is obviously very Joe Rogan inspired. It's pardon the mess. we work so hard here, mate, we don't have time to clean up.
Yeah, if I can see. Yeah. Ever.
This is a table where I interview players, and so this is a custom-made table off a Bloke off Gumtree. But also, I wanted to make them as relaxed as possible, give them a bit of space, so I asked for custom dimensions. Plus, I got the two smaller ones over here, custom-made. And this is from my producer. Now, if there was an award for the worst producer in the world, I think he may get it. I once caught him in the park, just around the corner. So this is when he first started. I'm talking a few weeks into the gig. Going for a run. Anyway, I see like these two people intertwined, like public affection, which is a big no-no in my opinion.
You're not a big PDA dude?
Hold hands, hug each other. But if you're passion on in the park,
you're not with it.
I'm not with that shit, man. It makes everyone else feel awkward. Or maybe it's just me. Have I repressed my sexuality? Is that what's going on right now?
There's clearly like so much thought has gone into it, but it's still masculine and you still have little references to rugby league all around. Like, you know, obviously we've got this wood and then there's nothing more rugby league, some would say, than a debit card on the table. So.
A lot of people, when they like want to create something, they want to be like flashy, like, oh, I want it to look futuristic or modern, and maybe I'm using the wrong terms. But what I was thinking was, all the things I choose in here have to be like salt of the earth kind of stuff, like strong, hard, real kind of stuff. So that's why I want you to see this. You also see the brick over here that I chose. Again, very masculine, strong. And also, it stood the test of time. And so, like, let's say you go to Europe, for example, and you see the buildings there.
Yeah.
Their trends have stood the test of time. Like, you go there, they're just as beautiful today, if not more, as they were 1,000 years ago. Whereas some of these modern buildings that were built in the 80s and that, they're gross. You're like, what? Here's another, like, a set.
Yeah, you gotta tell me about all this here, bro, because I'm actually really loving this.
So basically, I bought these two chairs just around the corner, and I put that book on there to look like I know things about cricket, but I have no clue about cricket, and I've never read that book. Matter of fact, every book in here has not been read by me, so.
You know what the classic thing is that if the book's on the table, you've never fucking read it.
Absolutely.
Because this is a big one. Is there a general difference between how you find the vibes on that, which is a lot more masculine, a lot more direct, whereas this is a lot more like casual?
Oh, for sure, absolutely. You're right, absolutely. Like, you can just already, when you're in this space, it feels like laid back, relaxed, almost as if you're in a lounge room.
Yeah. It's one of the things that we're trying to, like, I guess, really get across to the boys watching is that, you know, these little touches, these little nuances, these little, like, details, they actually make a severe difference, like, in your life, if you really, you know, allow them to.
You know, especially having a wife now, the home she's created, it just makes me happy.
Yeah.
Whereas, like, before, I just had
a place that I would go. Who gives a shit? It's a place to sleep.
Yeah, yeah.
Fucking put a PlayStation on a box and I'll be sweet.
But like, what, honestly, it can be as small as, you know, we joked around about the book before, but like that book adds character, adds something to this table that wasn't there.
Absolutely.
That's the tiniest little thing.
Yep, absolutely.
And look how much like difference it makes for you.
If you walk in as a bloke that loves sport, and like as soon as you sit down and you see a bunch of books there about sport, you're already in you love sport.
Yeah.
Like you're in your environment that you love. So
totally.
Yeah, I agree. Anyway, so
yeah, take us where next?
I'll take you to here. This is the main studio. This is where I give my unasked for opinion on rugby league. Where people, I don't know why, but they tune in by the thousands, mate.
You know what they call your podcast in the streets, eh?
What's that?
Blind leading the blind.
It is ironic. I grew up playing soccer and I was a winger. Like, if there was a combination to not listen to me, that would literally be it. Anyway, so this is the table that we got done. I wanted to make it...
Damn, man.
I just wanted to make it like a bar vibe.
No, you hit that because you got to talk to me about like this is such a subtle touch, but I remember noticing it the first time you revealed this place.
Mm.
You know, the corrugated iron.
Like our house roof was a tin roof. And so wherever it would rain.
That noise. Yeah.
And it was beautiful and I miss it so much. Like when it rains now, yeah. I can't hear it raining.
Yeah, no shit.
And whereas when I lived out like at home in Mudjibra, it's on about 5.5 acres. It was beautiful when it rained. It was like cozy and it gave me a sense of like contentment and safety in your own house. And so that's also the inspiration for that as well, because that the rain pattering on this is honestly not a better sound.
Fuck, that's mean, bro. That's so sick.
Got the mics to your corner, got the big, this actually lights up actually. I don't think it's connected at the moment though, because it's quite bright. Oh, actually, it might be. The ironic thing is we paid all this money to get it done. We can't use it because it blows out the cameras. Yeah. So it's like, yeah, that's inexperienced for it. Looks really cool, no one's ever seen it.
But you can, yeah.
Didn't need to pay for it, cost a lot of money. But it looks really cool, so.
Fuck my body.
Got these hand-drawn Alta. So Alta is a Melbourne graphic design. Matter of fact, Alta helped us with all of our branding, the bloke branding.
Shout out Alta.
Gave them like a little blurb of who they are, like as people kind of thing. And like, obviously Freddie's very like vibey and a bit different. Then you got the Rogue in Joey, and then the Battler in Thurston. That's why I kept his headgear on, because he's such a battler. And then this one, there was actually no blurb with Lockie. I literally just said, I need you to do a picture where his hair at the top of his chest is out and he has his collar up. Because that's how I remember Lockie. Got this made by a great mate, Damo. His name is Damo.
That's the most Aussie name.
Yeah, he's Aussie and he's as Aussie as they come.
Yeah.
So Damo at Event Vehicles, he custom made this. The fridge is cool, just got to fill it up a little bit more. Bloke beer bite now, Bottle-O's. All you Kiwis, it's coming, I promise. We're doing our best. And the great Jason Tamalolo, we got custom designs made by, I'm pretty sure Phantom Creative, apologies if I'm getting that wrong. Custom designs of one player from each team at the moment. It's on the great Jason Tamalolo. But over here, this is amazing. My pride and joy.
This is
my pride and joy. This can show you that I love sport and I've been doing it since I was a little whippersnapper. All the big stuff over there, it's great, but this is truly the trophy. We've got the old school Adidas's. We've got even the Lottos. The Lottos. The Total 90s. Let us know in the comment section, is the Total 90s the GOAT boot? Is it the GOAT boot? Because a lot of people say they are, Total 90s. The Puma Kings were the go-to. Then obviously got the yellow Nikes, but here it is. Guess how much these cost me on eBay? Yes.
$300.
$700 dues. $700 Australian.
That's like $750 New Zealand.
That's like $7,000 New Zealand.
Fuck, especially where our dollars going, brother.
These are personally, I think, the GOATs. These are the GOATs for me.
Yeah.
But only because I grew up playing soccer and David Beckham used to wear these. And he used to be the player that I wanted to, well, I was going to say look like, but...
So close to selling, Malcolm. But you've gone for kind of like the locker room look of it. Like, you haven't just lined them up.
For sure.
Like, you've very purposely put them
100%, 100%. Because, like, as again, if you really know sport, you know that any sporting athlete doesn't, like, X-Blades for Benji Marshall.
Really?
This is an ode to Benji Marshall, because he was the X-Blades guy. Because he was a stepper, and the yarn about these was like, they made you step better. Didn't work for me. This is a letter from a part of the community, the bloke community. The long story short, he says, a 25-year-old male with head noise, it is nice to have support from you and the bloke community. He said, in your interview with Junior Bolo, I remember you saying that you don't have many of your own jerseys.
You're kidding me. And that's what this is?
That's what this is, baby. What's crazy, he's saying thank you to me for the ongoing support. Like, are you serious, bro? Thank you to you. And yeah. So that's what this stuff like this keeps me really grounded in, like, how lucky, you know, I am to be doing what I'm doing. We got this poster here, Blokes Who Laid the Foundation. Obviously, again, bloke community, it's all about respect and also showing respect to people that came before you. And obviously, Matty Johns, Fatty, Bowie Ryan, some of the first guys in, like, content. This is where we do the reviews, the previews, and then here's the chill section. So yeah, this is where we chill out sometimes between, you know, we're talking, what are we going to talk about on the podcast? You know, what are we going to do? This couch is, again, from just around the corner.
Yeah, what's this place that you're... Do you remember what it's called?
I honestly don't even remember what it's called. This is from a different place to over there.
Yeah.
But yeah, when we saw it, I just loved it. I loved it. Got these round tables to kind of soften the area, but I feel like sometimes square and thick is quite masculine.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then obviously, here's the granddaddy of them all. This is where it all started. So
look at this.
But this is where the podcast started. Piece of material. This has Velcro on it. It comes out into a wall, so like a big wall. You've got the Velcro here, and we would Velcro that piece of material onto here. So on camera, because I've chosen a wall, it looks like a wall on camera, but in reality, it's all in all different places.
Yeah, yeah, got you. And, bro, can you talk me through, because I'm loving this.
Oh, this here?
I'm loving all of this here. Yep. Yeah, tell us about all this, man, because it's cool. Like, I want to know first, like, where's this carpet from?
Okay, so this carpet my wife picked.
Makes sense. What?
And again,
so tasteful.
Exactly. No, you're right. You're 100% right. We got something really, really soft.
It is really
almost
soft.
Almost like classical.
Yeah. Yeah, totally. It definitely does look quite vintage.
You wouldn't expect two tables and a carpet
to change the whole vibe,
but it really does. And then I'm a big believer in, like, yin and yang. Like, you know, you need your feminine energy, you need your masculine energy in regards to bringing a room together.
I mean, the way you're using this grate is... This breaks up this whole space, because it would feel super empty without these. Like, you're not necessarily using them.
Yeah. Cool thing as well is they actually, like, go in, they actually fit underneath each other. So if you want to, you can, like, make it just one table with different edges.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Strong, again, big, thick table that's got its, you know, kind of custom edges here. All the books down there. We've got the 100-inch TV I don't know why I did it.
The fuck?
I don't know why I did it.
100.
Am I compensating for something? Yeah. Yeah, I am.
Yeah, totally.
The reason why I got it, and it's going to sound silly, but if it was any smaller, like a 50-inch, it would look unbalanced.
Yeah.
Because the wall would be huge.
Yeah, it would look... You know, no worries on the compensating, bro. Like, I will just say, though, my TV's a laptop.
I only use my phone, bro. And so, yeah, we got this. So I had this custom made for Clint Gutherson.
And he sent it back.
No, he didn't say that. We asked for it back.
And he said, fuck off,
Kevin. He said, I don't even know you. Yeah. Who are you? Again, Damo, the great Damo, got it sorted for us. He's a gun, bro. He's a gun.
Shout out Damo, man.
Shout out fucking Damo. I'm telling you, the amount of stuff he's done for us has been incredible.
Yeah, thank you so much for showing me around, bro. Just before we finish up, I did just want to give you one last thing. So
let's go.
Got it for you. So it's customary, brother, for all the boys that come on the show, just as a massive thank you. Like, we know how much, you know, your day is filled up, so the fact you came and gave us this time, bro, really means a lot. And so I just wanted to give you your very own The Boys Are Decorating Tea.
Yes.
Large was the biggest we had. Sorry, brother. I know you wanted a small.
Man. I appreciate it. And I love what you're doing, bro. It's such an incredible idea. And it's just good to see the boys decorating.
That's what we're here for.
No, so, bro. And I've got a beer for you.
I don't know if you know this, but I got a beer company. But cheers, bro.
Appreciate you, brother.
Cheers.
Thanks so much. Let's see. Let's see.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, fuck. Holy fuck. Thank you so much, everybody, for watching. This has obviously been the boys are decorating with the amazing Denan Kemp, the one and only bloke in a bar. Thank you so much to the Land Collective for supporting this episode. Make sure you go and check out all the links below that I've thrown in, and really show some love to the boys, because they're showing some love to the boys.
100%, bro. Appreciate it, man. Thank you so much.
Love you so much, man.
Chest hair is making a comeback, I reckon. And it's hurting me because I can't grow any.
You don't have any?
I don't have any chest hair.
None.
Bro, literally none.
Is that natural there?
That is natural,
bro.
Are
you serious?
I swear to God, it's the only good part about me.
Congrats, bro.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
Dang.